UK Prime Minister Theresa May vowed to ban gay conversion procedures in her country.
No!
This was a victory for the LGBTQ community, which had long been lobbying to get the practice outlawed. But what does it have to do with us, here in India? Many of us believe that the only sexual reorientation that we are guilty of is Baba Ramdev's empty words about curing homosexuality with yoga. He also claims to cure cancer, by the way, using the same.
Oh, yeah.
Apart from this, we've only upheld religious mores, ridiculed homosexuality in films, and for whoever was still not discouraged, outlawed the act altogether. This is all that we are guilty of. Wrong. The year is 1977. And 6 subjects are selected for sexual reorientation at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences. But more on that in a moment. Let's dial back to what sexual reorientation actually is. Gay conversion is sometimes called sexual reorientation. It is the belief that one's sexuality can be changed from homosexual to heterosexual through medical procedures. This is not the occult, this is not yoga, but Western medicine. See for yourself. 1 physical, 3 psychological approaches. Physical endocrinal therapy, psychoanalysis, psychotherapy, and behavior therapy. It was this last one that was chosen by psychiatrist Dr. S.N. Deshpande and her colleague Dr. M. Mehta for their experiment that claimed to have successfully achieved sexual reorientation in 4 out of 6 individuals.
Aversion therapy, in your opinion, does it work in today's day and age if the person wants to convert his sexual orientation?
Yeah, it still works. I recently also I did on one person and he was benefited by that.
So how did this outlandish and inhumane experiment, which wouldn't be out of place in a sci-fi movie, happen? These persons were asked to bring sexually stimulating materials. All were asked to bring photographs of 8 males and 8 females, which were sexually stimulating to the subjects, ranging from fully clothed to nude. All chose to bring music with sexual emotional content to reinforce their sexual feelings. One decided to bring a perfume that they found stimulating. The doctors showed them the pictures and asked them to activate sexual feelings. Then they administered a 50-volt shock when the subject was looking at a stimulating picture of the same sex. In contrast, their favorite music was played, and for that one subject, perfume was dissipated when they looked at pictures of the opposite sex. This was not unlike what Skinner did to rats. You can see from this result that these doctors are a little bit obsessed with the whole institution of marriage. Subject 1, result improved. Follow-up, got married. Subject 2, improved, got married. Subject 3, improved, better relationship with wife. Subject 4, stopped homosexual contacts, not married yet. Subject 5 and 6, as you can see, dropped out and failed to complete the treatment. We don't know whether they got married. Oh, and by the way, these were published in the Indian Journal of Psychiatry, the premier publication on the subject. Homosexuals have faced exclusion and persecution for centuries. This is a map of the world that shows societal attitudes towards homosexuality as of 2013. Though data was not processed for India, the situation is, well, bad. These countries have banned gay conversion already. It's time India followed suit.